When I first came to the school, the person at the desk said to me, I told him I was insecure about learning this craft and didn't think I was qualified, considering all the brilliant artists that come here. He said, we've been waiting for you a long time. That nice introduction. I said, well, I'm here.
No, I knew I had a calling. And so it was like, when I was in Saudi Arabia and Egypt and Italy, I just knew it was what I had to be doing. But I kept procrastinating. We all do that.
I said, you got to stop procrastinating. You're not going to be young like it. Life is going to pass you by, kid. You better do what you want. I enrolled here. It's just gotten better. It gets better every day. It's sort of what you put into it. Isn't this cool? The little twists coming up here. And there comes a point with each sculpture that you just feel finished with it. And I'm coming along with Tower now. It's feeling getting there now. What I'm trying to do is bring closure to my piece here. But it's pretty ready for painting, pretty much.
You know, it's hard, it's difficult to explain my story with Grey Gardens, isn't it, Chris?
I think so.
It's really, really difficult to explain.
It's complicated.
Grey Gardens?
Yes.
The film?
Yes.
It's very good.
Well, I'm the guy from the movie. And here we are. 2010, it is like a cult film. Just the most remarkable circumstances. Put together three people in one place. I knock on the front door, and Edie comes down the front of the staircase in the mansion. It was covered with cobwebs. It was the tunnel in which you would travel to the front door. The house was so vintage, Great Gardens. And Edie opens the front door and says, oh, the marble Faun. I said, I don't know who that is, but if you need any help with the property, I'll be willing to, more than willing to help you. I was just more than curious. I didn't know what to say when she opened the door. Come back in the morning, talk to mother. It's so unique that these two women could survive for 25 years, maybe more, in a mansion with virtually no hot water, no plumbing, no food, just on the wits, and who they were related to. She was Jacqueline Kennedy's aunt. They had a lot of history to that family. It was like amazing. During our relationship, Mrs. Bill told me about the Bouvier altar in St. Patrick's Cathedral. They have an altar in that cathedral. I said, you have an altar in St. Patrick's Cathedral.
Because of American royalty.
It was. She said, yeah, when you go there and put flowers on the altar for Easter for me. I took the train and really not sure if this was going to materialize. Really not sure if there was an altar in St. Patrick's Cathedral. So I went there, and sure enough, there's their altar. They are the real thing. They were American royalty. I didn't know my life was going to get in so much trouble after I left. It's such a fascinating place. Just love New York City.